Stick with me, and you'll never go hungry again. Stick with me, and you'll never go hungry again. Stick with me, and you'll never go hungry again.
Hello again, guys. So it's another work in progress video, and this one showing how I reanimated a shot from the Be Prepared original scene from the original movie, aka the best movie, not that remake bullshit. We don't talk about that one. But this is the reanimated project that we did together with a whole bunch of animators, and we're just going to talk through how we did each step and why I changed up some of the original and why I kept some of it the same. So the first step, it was just a very rough sketch, really, really basic blocked out sketch. Not even any lip syncing on this, literally just some body movements. In terms of the body movements, it's probably the only thing I really toyed with heavily from the original shot. Personally, I've never liked that crazy face that Scar does when he says me. It didn't fit to me. It always looked too comical, and I wanted him to look more menacing rather than just like crazy. I never really got menacing from the original, so I did want to change that. And at the end, instead of just him leaning up and going hungry again, I wanted him to be more handsy and really, really dramatic with his hands. People who tend to be the best public speakers tend to be the ones who are very dramatic with their hands and are very artistic with their hands, and even the villains of history are very artistic with their hands, and it makes them very charismatic. So I really wanted to add a bit more sort of hand expression, because he uses his hands a lot in this song, so why not use it here as well? Then this next work in progress shot is just him doing the same movements again, but just with some lip sync frames added on top of it, just so I could have an idea of where to block out for the lines on top. Like I say, a lot of this is still very, very choppy, but it gives an idea of what mouth shapes are where. Then this one is the blocky line art, so the what we call the keyframe line art. There's no in-betweens done in here, so you can see it's really choppy still, but you're getting in more of an idea of the movement, you're getting an idea of the lip sync, and you're getting kind of an idea of how he's going to shape. Then this one is the in-between one, so this is the complete line art. As you can see on the bottom, his line art at the bottom is crazy wiggling around, because that's going to be underneath rock, so that doesn't need to be consistent, but it just looks a mess when you're exporting it. When you're going behind a background object, it's just so much easier just to not animate it really and just pop it on at the end. There's no point animating behind it and just having it as a layer in the way on top. Just draw a sketch for it so you know vaguely where it is, and then just don't put it on until the last minute. Then here we can see color-wise. This shot in terms of coloring was quite challenging, because in the middle of it, he changes from a whole color palette to another color palette, because the light turns on, basically. He moves from the green palette to the amber palette, and I'm like, aha, how do we do this? Do we fade it, or do we just chop it? So I tried it with a fade, and I ended up getting like two frames in and thinking, this looks shite, basically. So I just switched from one palette to the next, and actually with the background fading, you don't even notice it at all. All you notice is that his colour palette has changed, so I didn't need to bother with the fading at all. I just chopped and changed from one frame to the next, and nobody noticed. Ta-da! Then this next one, I'm sort of compiling together the two of them, is the coloured shot with the rock that he sets on top of the file, and then there's also the other shot is the same exact sequence, but the entire color has been blocked in solid. And what I did with this is when I dragged these into Sony Vegas and used the chroma key and used some effects to distort the whole video, I could lay it against the background, change the shape of it, rise it up a bit, and sort of match it up with the other one to make it look like Scar's shadow, because I was tempted to reanimate it, but I just thought, wow, what a lot of effort, and it won't match at all. So I tried this in the editing program just to see if I could do as a corner cutting mission, and also just to make it a little bit better, and it looked sick. And as you can see in this final product, I'm really quite happy with how it came out. It's pretty true to the original. I tried to make the background as much of a carbon copy as I could from the original, because I just thought that was really, really good. But I like how the movement works. The shadow and things on the wall works really, really well. The only thing that I regret a little bit is that the scale is not quite there. It's a bit too small. He needs to be a bit smaller in that end shot. But you know what? I'll tolerate it. It's okay, and the thing is, it's now done. So that's how I made this Be Prepared shot. Please go and watch the final project, because it has been a mammoth effort between something like 45 animators to get this done. The final product looks insane, and you would really be missing out if you didn't go and watch this, so I strongly recommend you go and watch it. I will put a link in the description. Go and have a check out of it. Really appreciate it, and so would all the other animators. Till next time, my darlings, bye-bye!